Hit it. You know the man still in black and white.
Another century is over, a new millennium is here. I think it's reflection time for everyone everywhere. Time to take a good look at what's happening to our planet, in the land and the sea and in the atmosphere. We ought to search for solutions to rid this earth of pollution and environmental destruction globally. Clean up this world we are living for the generation to come, and look for a peaceful world for this incoming millennium, so that society could exist in harmony with nature's natural ecosystem. Cause in our quest for wealth and prosperity, just destroying nature's harmony, creating a big global problem. We got to ask ourselves over and over again, what kind of world we live in for tomorrow's children? What kind of world we live in for tomorrow's children? Nation and its society is not only material and cultural achievement, but those little things that nature so lovingly put together to form a biological development. But if one ton of human desires deplete all these earthly treasures in the name of economic development, resources may disappear completely, leaving tomorrow's children and their future in jeopardy. That's why I wonder if there are bitter days to come sometime later in this prevailing millennium, because such delusion as greed for power, killing the planet by the hour, we're moving without any wisdom. We got to ask ourselves over and over again,
what kind of world we live in for tomorrow's children?
Let me hear you.
What kind of world we live in for tomorrow's children?
Of nature we used to be grateful for, but somehow humanity has lost its feeling of awe. Now science is taking over, religion is losing power, and the ecosystem is feeling it more and more. And as we keep on advancing in this reckless way of life, the atmosphere around us keep warming up. It might be a millennium of war for children of tomorrow. Life as we know it might stop if this devastation of our relationship with nature ought to be conducive and moving in harmony. But if we keep destroying the source of life, how long are we going to survive? Well, it won't last out indefinitely. We have to ask ourselves over and over again,
what kind of world we live in for tomorrow's children? What kind of world we live in for
A person went to the central bank with a whole ton load of money. The manager gets suspicious, so he called the police immediately. Oh, where you get this amount of money? The policeman asks the person. You better come with the truth, otherwise your backside go into prison. But he said, oh, you set up for unbelievers. You wouldn't understand. This is 19 years of tithes and offering from my congregation. They were bringing in money. Bringing in money. Yes, they came rejoicing. Bringing in money. I didn't try to stop them, and I never will. That is how I got these $100 bills. The police say that the answer he giving them ain't making sense. So they decide they're going to take a search at the clergy man's residence. They were shocked when they find a few more millions hidden below his bed. And instead of clothes, well, the parcel closet was packed up with cash instead. But he tell them, all you don't blame me is to the Lord this cash was given. I told them if they bring the money to the church, they all will be going to heaven. So they were bringing in money. I tell you, bringing in money. Yes, they came rejoicing,
bringing in money.
God didn't try to stop them, and they never will. And that is how I got these $100 bills. Well, if you see the passing face, how he's looking pious and holy, trying to convince the bank that the church people were giving the money. He say, I told them if they bring in the cash, eventually will be sure. When you bring in the cash, I'm telling you, in return, you'll get plenty more. Some of them even sell their house. I don't know for how much. But they all declare they want to go to heaven, so they bring the cash to the church. They were bringing in money.
Bringing in money.
Yes, they came rejoicing.
Bringing in money.
I didn't try to stop them, and I never will. That is how I go.
$100 bill.
Come, bring in some more money. Come and bring some more money.
As money troubles everything, I read that in Leviticus. So why don't you just change up the money and stop making all this fuss? Although it's looking suspicious, this is junk money. I tell them to bring the money to the church, they've gone to heaven already. So you think it's really time, the man looking pious and holy. And if you don't change this money tonight, all are you going to hell? I tell you there will be
pain and money, pain and money.
Yes, they can rejoice
in pain and money.
I didn't try to stop.